How's it going, guys? Welcome back to another quick little video, and I'm sorry that I didn't post for a long time, but my PC fucked up. But yeah, we're back in Fallout New Vegas, and today we're going to do something special. I got this idea from a friend, and I want to thank him. But today we're going to start a sniper-only run. We're going to play Fallout New Vegas only with snipers, and it's going to be so difficult at the beginning. Because I'm not allowed to use anything like the varmint rifle. And I'm going to be playing on very hard, so yeah, let's see where it goes, right?
How about your name? Can you tell me your name?
Oh man, I can tell you my name! Pussy Slayer! XXX! Hell yeah, that's my name! Okay, we're gonna be a female, because why the fuck not? Yeah. I got all these races. Fuck that. I'm going to go with Vanessa Nabila, whatever. Now I like her hairstyle. I want her to be like a suit or whatever. How the fuck you pronounce that word? And so yeah, this is me. Okay, so fucking Vidomatic vigor test, whatever. Okay, guys. So. The character special build. This is going to be one of the most important parts of the whole game. That's because, you know, sniper rifles tend to get heavy. I mean, the anti-material rifle requires 8 strength points in order to use correctly. What I'm going to do is subtract 1 point of charisma, add 4 points of intelligence, and add 2 points of agility. That way, I can use intense special training, which has 10 ranks, to improve on my strength, my agility, and my luck. So now we have to do this mental checkup with Doc Mitchell, and I'm going to skip this part because it's the same for everybody, so yeah, I'll see you guys later, I suppose. Okay, so the skills are very important because, you know, kinda need to survive out there. So one of the most important skills is guns, because of course most of the sniper rifles are a part of the guns skill, not the energy weapon skill. The second one is going to be sneak, and the third one is going to be speech, because I want to get out of fights whenever I can. I want to avoid fights most of the time. So the traits that I'm going to pick are trigger discipline and good-natured, because good-natured is always handy, and trigger discipline, you know, sniper rifles don't really shoot that fast anyway, but it's better to have that 20% more accuracy. Okay, so we just got our stuff from Doc Mitchell, and of course we got the DLC shit and the DLC guns. Now what I'm going to do is loot this place down just a tiny bit, so we can get some more shit. I just love this intro. Whenever you come out of Doc Mitchell's house, and yes, I understand all old blues and shit, but I just love this this intro from whenever you get out of Doc Mitchell's house, of the city and everything with the light. Okay, it's just gorgeous. Okay, so what we're going to do now is just, I don't know, talk to Victor or some shit. So first thing we want to do is avoid the salon, because that will automatically start the tutorial. What we actually want to do now is head over to the cemetery, wherever the fuck that thing is, and grab a snow globe. So we got to the grave, and from what I can see, there are no bloatflies here, which is weird because I never came to the graves, the graveyard before doing the tutorial with Sunny Smiles. And this is what we came for, snow globe, good springs. Okay, now that we got that piece of shit, we have a long, it's actually not that long, but we have a pretty long walk over to Prim. Oh, and apparently this is the grave that that Victor dug me out of, and you can find these distinctive cigarette butts that are from Benny, and you can show this as evidence to the guy that works with him at the Tops casino, and therefore you could convince him to let you in to deal with Benny without doing that much speech checking and shit. So I just found out Jean skydiving, and it's weird because this is the first time that I came here without the powder gangers actually being hostile to me. So that's cool, you know, I'm okay with that. So we'll just continue heading on forward to Prim. I just want to let you guys know that I will pick up any guns and any ammo that I'll find and probably sell it later in order to gamble most of my money and get a profit. And okay, that was a mine. I just walked over a fucking mine. I completely forgot that this place is mined. I'm surprised that I'm still at full health and I don't have any of my limbs crippled. Oh fuck. Okay, so just split my dick and call me Caitlin. Okay, I'm out of fucking, I'm out of this fucking place. I already lost health. Yeah, you see kids, this is why this shit is dangerous as fuck. Because, okay, we already see our first gecko out there, and I can't use a gun to snipe him because I don't have a sniper rifle, okay? So, I guess I'll just have to deal with it. Oh, this is that scripted event that shows that geckos are more powerful than rat roaches. Okay. I like how these geckos... Holy f- No, I'm out. I'm out. I was about to say that I love how these geckos usually don't follow you after they kill the rat roach, but it's not true in this case. Prospector, help me. Oh, yes. I know this is kind of cheating, but I'm using the prospector to kill the geckos, you know? You know, I don't want to die in the first 5 minutes of this video, so yeah, let's just continue. So we just arrived at Prim, and there's this scripted event with an NCR trooper. Yeah, I can take care of myself. I have over 120 hours in Fallout New Vegas, and I just found out that there are these ammo crates right here. What the? I'm in caution. Why am I in caution? Why? Okay, now we got to this little shack. I don't want to call it a shack. I don't know what the fuck this is. But as you can see, there are mines out there. And we also have some more ammo crates, so why the fuck not? So I just helped myself to that ammo over there. Thank you. See you later. And I just gotta take care of these mines right quick. Okay, that was a close one. That was an even close one. So, guys, we just arrived at Prim. Now, what I want to do is head over to the NCR tents. To be honest, I completely forgot where they are. Turns out there's a magazine right here. Some more ammo boxes up on this roof. I'm okay with it. Turns out there's a storm coming up. Fuck me, right? Is this some kind of sandstorm? You know what? I'll just wait this out. So, this is the next morning. I just waited in that corner for like 19 hours. And, I think I know where the tents are. I just crossed that bridge with the mines on them. On it. Turns out I don't have to. Yeah, I risked my life for nothing, basically. Oh, yeah, I was right. Here they are. Okay. Now, why did we come here? I'm not sure in which one of these tents there's like a footlocker with some NCR armor, like that one. And why are you pointing at me? Whatever. We need our armor in order to get into Camp Mccaran and use their monorail in order to get to the strip without paying the 4,000 caps. So I'm gonna start with this one and see if that thing is inside. Oh yeah, perfect, it's right here. So we have to get this NCR bandolier armor, and the trooper helmet is not necessary. I'm just gonna leave it here because I don't deal with helmets. And I found some more ammunition. Yeah, what the fuck not? So we got what we wanted out of Prim. Now here comes the hardest part of our whole like little adventure here at the beginning. We have to get to Camp Mccaran. I have to get to Camp Mccaran because there is a sniper rifle on one of those beds over there. And, you know, I kind of want to get there in one piece without traveling for like 20 hours. So I have to go by the Deathclaw quarry. That is what's going to get me killed. So we just teleported to Gene skydiving and we're going to the Deathclaw quarry. And I just can't get used to the fact that the powder gangers won't attack me because I didn't attack them. And Crimson Caravan Guards, dead. Okay, I'm gonna get their armor and shit. More ammunition, hell yeah, energy cells. Today's physician, I don't think I will ever need that, but whatever. We'll just head on over to the Deathclaw quarry. Apparently there are some enemies right here. And they're not moving. Oh no, they are moving, they're just like mongrels or some shit. Oh, they may be crows. Yeah, crows usually are enemies in vats for some reason. Okay, I have a question. What the fuck is happening over there? Like, really? Engineers? Oh! Oh, this is one of the mods that I installed. Electricity engineers. NCR mercenaries and lots of fucking Brahmin. Okay, that's actually really cool. They actually, apart from adding lights, they actually add NPCs as well. Let's see if we can talk to them. Yeah, I can't talk to any of them. But this building, this cart right here is really interesting. Yeah, this is new. That's really cool. So let's just continue heading on to Deathclaw Quarry. Okay, so I just told this guy that I'll take care of his Deathclaw problem. Yeah, not today, man. Not today. And what's up with this road right here, man? So low quality. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to nip in Sloan right now. And see if I can get any quests from around here. So I tried fixing this poor thing's leg, and I'm just 2 points off. Cruel life, man, cruel life.
Let me ask you a question. What's the tastiest thing you've ever eaten?
Pussy. So this bitch wants a Deathclaw egg. Yeah, we'll see in about 1,000 years. So, here comes the hard part. I just basically have to... Oh, the road is fixed. Okay. I just have to loop around the Deathclaws. Like, right here, and have to use my sneak a lot. I'm gonna have to stick around to this mountain right here. So I just remember that we basically have to wait till nighttime. Oh, fuck. You cannot wait when enemies are nearby. What does... Okay, fuck it. I'm heading back to Sloan. So I can wait right here, and we're gonna wait till nighttime. Okay, so it's midnight, and turns out that Nevada lights or something like that. Oh no, yeah, Nevada Weathers has a blue night mod that I accidentally installed. I thought it would only make the sky blue, but turns out that it makes the all darkness blue. Holy fuck, there are some enemies right there. What are they? Vats can't detect them. And that's the entrance to the quarry. Holy fuck, I'm still hidden. So far that's good. And I didn't kill Joe Cobb, so I don't have a stealth boy yet. There's a shack right there. I don't know if I should go there. What's up with this ground, man? I keep seeing this glitch, like, textures not popping in. But I'm just going to avoid that place. And I think I saw a rat, not rat roaches, but rat scorpions. Oh. I see a Deathclaw. Right there. I can't zoom in on it. Oh, okay, this is gonna be tough. Holy fuck. Okay, so... I'm going to do what a great man once said. Quick save is my only save right here. So I just dropped a quick save. Let's see if we can get past these Deathclaws without them spotting us. Okay, so that's only detected this one Deathclaw, and fuck, that thing looks menacing. Oh fuck. That one is right on the train tracks. That's gonna be so fucking close. Can I even do that? Oh. Okay, the other one is super fucking close. That's too close for comfort. I think that it just found me. I'm in caution and it turned around. One more. Okay, I'm fucking scared. Oh no, I'm in danger. Fuck. What detected me? Okay, there's something moving right there. From what I remember, those can be rat scorpions. I'm not sure. Oh, back in danger. I don't want to risk it. That's a fucking Deathclaw! Two fucking Deathclaws, okay. Oh fuck! Oh, no, I'm out! I'm out, bitch!
Run, bitch! Run!
Holy fuck, they're after me. Oh fuck! Fuck, 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 fuck! I just increased my brightness a little bit and yeah, I'm back to... Okay. Okay. I cannot wait when enemies are nearby. So, this fucking storm just had a fucking lightning strike. Oh, fuck. There's a Deathclaw right there. Okay, no. I'm reloading. So, what I'm going to do is take a bigger swing. So let's look on our pit point. I basically try to go right next to the road, and those Deathclaws are right on this little patch of fucking train roads right there. What I'm going to do, even though this is Black Mountain and Super Mutant territory, I'm going to take a bigger swing. Maybe that way, like this. Maybe that way they won't find me. But I just gotta find a way to get on these mountains. They're not actually mountains, they're just cliffs, whatever. Yeah, I'm not good with this type of shit. Okay, I just climbed this little hill and Super Mutants right there. So Super Mutants on my right, Deathclaws on my left. I just gotta be as agile as a fucking cat, otherwise I'm dead. Okay, so I'm a little bit higher than before, so Deathclaws can't reach me as easily. But I'm still really close. Like, last time I was on that road over there and Deathclaws are everywhere. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and climb this little hill or something. Please tell me I can. Please tell me I can. I don't want to fall. Oh, maybe. Oh, fuck. Come on. You dirty bitch. So I just backtracked my way over here and oh fuck, this is tough. Super Mutants are over there. Like, you can see them roaming around over there. And one over there, okay. Two over there. Fuck. And I can't climb this. Oh yeah, there you go. Vash just detected them. And I can't climb this little thing right here, or maybe I can. Wait, let me see. Let me see. Please tell me I can. Fuck. No, you gotta be fucking kidding me. I managed to climb this thing, but there's an invisible wall right here. You gotta be fucking kidding me. Okay. Plan B. I'm gonna wait even longer. So now it's like 5 a.m. and the sun will start rising in a little bit. Ah, Deathclaws are right there. You know what? Fuck it. Back to my original strategy. But this time I'll be more careful. I'm already in fucking caution. I just said I'm going to be more careful. Okay. Wait 1 hour. Sun is rising and I'm still in caution. That Deathclaw is looking at me. Okay. I'm done. I'm in danger. Fuck me. So now I just basically became Spider Woman, as you can see. And oh my god, I just made it up. Okay. Deathclaws right fucking there. Those guys got me last time. What I'm going to do is, since I'm not way past Black Mountain, but I'm still quite a distance away, so I'm going to try and do this huge swing around those Deathclaws. God, these Deathclaws are so perceptive. So now I'm not even running while crouching, I'm walking while crouching. That's how fucking scared I am. Okay, one of them is right there. Another one is right there. Fuck, I gotta be as cautious as I can. Those Fallout 4 brackets would really help me right now, you know? They would let me know how close Deathclaws are to finding out what I actually am. So I'm still in caution apparently, and I'm quite far away from those Deathclaws, but I don't want to start running again. Okay, three Deathclaws right there. I'm in danger. A Deathclaw's coming for me. I'm fucked. Now I'm just gonna run over here, hide in this little corner. I'm just gonna wait it out. Good, that was a good decision. Now I'm back and hidden. And the Deathclaw's not in front of me. I just hope it's not over there somewhere. It just went back to its natural position. That's just a rock. I thought that was the Deathclaw. I almost just fucking shat myself right there. So, the first time when they killed me, and by the way, yeah, they killed me in one strike. That's how powerful they are. I tried hiding in that building over there, and I just didn't get there in enough time. And there's that motherfucking Deathclaw that always finds me. And now it's coming my way, so I'm just gonna bust some ass. And by bust some ass, I mean running while crouching. Guys, I don't wanna jinx myself, but I think that I may be safe from the Deathclaws. Oh my god. Okay, that was the most intense shit I did in a while. My heart was beating so fast while I was in caution. What I'm going to do is I'm gonna head over to Camp Mccaran. I can see it. I'm so close to it, but there's still some ground in between us, and I might get killed. Like, this is not a joke. Okay, I didn't find Deathclaws, but I found fire ant soldiers, fire ant workers. You know what I said, that Camp Mccaran is so close, but there still might be some dangers in between us? Yeah, I fucking jinxed myself. And I got detected for a second there, and I didn't go into caution. That's a Brahmin, but I don't want to risk it. Oh fuck, that's a little one, that's a little one, okay. I mean, detected. Hidden. Okay, it saw me, but it didn't give a fuck. Yeah, that's what I want. Okay. Okay, right as I said that, fiends. Fucking fiends. Oh, okay. No, you fucking bitch, don't get tired on me. I'm seeing someone. I can't. That's NCR trooper! NCR trooper! Okay. I got some armor on. That bitch is so close. I'm fucking lucky that she got a bullet here and she doesn't have a fucking weapon. NCR, please fucking help me kill this bitch. I mean, I won't fucking damage her, but you can. And what is that? Okay, laser shits. Okay. NCR actually helped me. Okay, thank you. And I'm just gonna loot the corpse. Nothing good. Nope. So lasers and NCR. What's happening over there? I honestly don't want to find out. Holy shit! Fiends with actual laser weapons. Okay, she's so close to dying. I'm actually gonna step in. Okay, good. I didn't get any speed. Good, okay. I'm gonna get the laser rifle, my confusion cells, and pack of cigarettes. Okay. That's good. Another bitch with a fucking pull cue. Okay, so I got some weapons. I got some loot. And I knew that there were fiends going to be in this area, but not this close. Camp Mccaran is just there. Like, come on, I'm going to bust some ass. Okay, that's an SCR trooper. I thought there was going to be a fiend. Holy fuck, you don't know how tense this was. I'm in hidden. Okay, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put on that that armor. There we go, NCR Bandolier armor. I'm now dressed as a member of the NCR, so they'll think that I'm NCR, basically, which I'm not. I'm neutral to them. Oh, come on, man. I'm NCR, man. Come on, just... We're best friends, right? You're Carl, right? Yeah, I remember that shit. Tell your daughter I said hi. Yo, my wife too, whatever. Okay, so... Guys, we made it. We're at the NCR. Camp Mccaran. Oh, man, those Deathclaws. They're just destroying you if you're not paying attention. I just gotta find the bunk with the sniper rifle. But I just found these here supplies and I'm still detected. I mean, I'm NCR. I'm not NCR, but I'm dressed as an NCR. I suppose I could just get them, but I don't want to try, so. Okay. So, yeah, I don't want to get shot at by fucking NCR right now. Corporal Betsy, you're a named character.
Hey, girl. You need something from me?
Like some... Do you have Psycho on you? Yeah, Psycho's good. Turns out that Corporal Betsy is a lesbian. Well, you know, I'm a woman. My character's a woman. Yeah, let's see where this goes. So, I got scared shitless because I thought that the gun was on the bunk bed. Turns out it was right here. What I'm going to do is... Control Z so I can pick it up and, you know, I'm gonna take her on a little adventure. Okay, I'm in hidden. Oh, there we go. First gun. Sniper rifle. Hell to the yes. First gun. Bonus critical chance. I only got 16 bullets for it. And it only has 15 damage. But fuck it. Terrible, terrible condition. But hey, still works, right? And since I'm hidden, I'm gonna steal some more supplies. I wonder if there's a shop inside the camp. Because I really want some bullets.
He's taking a shit right now. Takes his time.
Okay, so go on through soldier. I suppose this is the door to the monorail. Yeah, I was right, this is the monorail. Let's go to the strip. Guys, girls, Apache helicopters, a sexy Pringle ready to mingle. We did it. We're at the strip. Okay, we get it. You're sexually stressed because Mr. House doesn't let you get any fucking weapons in here. I can take care of that, that stress. Oh yeah. Spank me, daddy! Okay, what the fuck was that?
Hey.
Hey. Oh man.
Daddy!
Oh, I just can't get rid of you, Victor. Okay, yeah, I'll go there straight off. Yeah, sure, whatever. Your day's gonna come, Benny. Your day is gonna come. So, lucky 38, we have to get here. Hola, Victor.
Howdy, partner. Good to see you again. Boss is waiting for you.
We just saw each other like 30 seconds ago. You gotta be fucking kidding me. You gotta be Bitch! You are just outside. I came in here first. What the fuck are you doing here?
What floor, partner?
Mr. House. We finally meet. Fucking people calling me and shit. But Mr. House, we finally meet after all this time. You are the true daddy that everybody's been wanting. So spank me. Oh wait, spank me. I'm ready.
Daddy.
So that's it. We talked to House. Now, one more thing we gotta do while we're still in here and is in the Lucky 38. Enjoy. Oh, thank you. Now, what we gotta do is go to the cocktail lounge. And, you know, I really like this area. It's really beautiful. I mean, apart from the glitchiness over there, this is a really beautiful area. It's a shame that they don't use it. What we came for here. Snow globe test site. Second snow globe. Do you know what that means? I know what it means. It means that we have two snow globes. Yeah, 1 + 1 = 4. Nice, math. We gotta go to the penthouse again. Now we just gotta talk to Jane, Mr. House's secretary. And a lady doesn't kiss and tell. No, but she sucks and swallows. Yeah, what's with the snow globe collection? Not many people. Well, what do you know? I've got some snow globes. You do? Well, that's just wonderful. And that's what we came here for, folks. 4,000 caps. Yeah, that's quite a lot. Considering that, yeah, we're still level 1. So we have 4,018 caps. What we have to do now is, of course, we gotta talk to Victor. And from the strip, we gotta go to Freeside. Okay, now that we're in Freeside, things are going to get interesting. What we're going to do is head over to the New Vegas Clinic for an intelligence implant. And here it is, the New Vegas Medical Clinic. Let's head in and buy that intelligence implant. So now we're back to being broke, I guess. I only have 18 caps. So, what I'm going to do now is wait until the morning, because apparently it's night out. And it's a foggy morning. I'm okay with that, you know, I'm okay with that. What we gotta do is head on over to the Gun Runners, because I actually don't have any money at all. I only have 18 caps. So now we're at Freeside's East Gate. I'm gonna make right and I'm gonna head over to the Gun Runners. And I'm gonna make some money from selling a lot of weapons. I only have like 2 spare capacity left, so yeah. That will really help me. Oh, there it is. Anti-material rifle. 8,000 caps though, I only have 18. You know, I'll make a deal. I'll give you 18 caps and a pretty damaged 9mm pistol for that anti-material rifle of yours. Let's actually sell everything. So, he already ran out of money because he only has 1,000 caps because I'm such a low level. But I'm going to buy a lot of 308 ammo from him. So now I have 829 caps. That's, you know, quite a lot. Yeah, quite a lot. So, you know, I think we did enough for today. So, we delivered 2 globes to Mr. House. We got over to Prim. We went past the quarry to head over to the Camp Mccaran to get the sniper rifle. And got caught by Deathclaws for like 3 times. I took a monorail to the strip. I got an intelligence implant. And I made 100 caps. And this is just the first episode, you know, I think that this is a good enough start for this series. Now, I want to thank you guys for enjoying this longer video, and I want to tell you that I'm sorry for not posting for a long time, because I've had problems with my PC lately. Like, my old motherboard was having problems, and I'm saying old because I bought another motherboard, and this one so far doesn't give me any troubles. I hope it'll stay that way. So again, thanks for watching this awesome hard video of Fallout New Vegas sniper only run. Peace.